Well, we know her best from her starring role in the hit show Wentworth, but it's another role that's fed Danielle Cormack's passion. She's just returned from Moldova, a poor country that borders Ukraine, where she's been working as an ambassador for Child Fund Australia and New Zealand. And Danielle is back and she's with us now on our couch. It's good to see you.
Good morning.
Wow, that is a confronting trip to take, right? You visited a Ukrainian refugee centre in Moldova.
Yeah.
What did you find? What did you see?
So, well, first and foremost, I was there. There are these mobile sites that are distributing packs for mothers and children, so giving them nutritious snacks and giving them basic essentials, toiletries and so forth, because a lot of the people who have fled Ukraine, a lot of the mothers and children, because most of the men are having to stay there and fight, have just left with nothing. So they have no toiletries, they don't have any sanitary products. So they've been handing out those, but they're also giving the kids snacks and also toys to play with because they don't have anything. So I was at one of those mobile sites handing them out, meeting the kids. The Alliance had put on all these amazing activities for the kids, so face painting, painting, song and dancing, and it was songs and performance and so forth. So it was lovely to see the kids having a moment just to be kids and to also fraternise with the other children as well because they haven't been socialised in the last wee while. Yeah. But yes, I did go to the refugee accommodation centres. Moldova is an incredibly poor country. It's one of the poorest countries in Europe, so they've already got enough strain on them. Yeah. So they're opened up their old schools to house the refugees, the mothers and kids that have come over. It's a very moving, very sad, desperate situation. It's an emergency. There's a crisis there. But what I loved about what the Alliance is doing is that they're giving a moment of respite for the parents and the kids at the moment. And that's, for me, it's like, this is what people's support is doing, allowing these kids just to play with some toys, to have a moment just to, like, you know, you can see on the screens now where the kids are able just to have some fun.
Where are they living and are the kids able to go to school? What's the situation?
No, a lot of them aren't. They are a lot of them. The Moldovan people have opened up their homes. A lot of them very kindly. They're being billeted out. There are some refugee accommodation centres, but there's simply not enough space at the moment to house everybody. Luckily, there are some families that have got friends and colleagues in Moldova, so they're housing them. There are so many displaced people from Ukraine right now, and even within their own country. And neighbouring countries. I think Poland has taken in a lot of refugees. I haven't been to those territories yet, only to Moldova. Everyone's on their toes at the moment because a lot of the alliances aren't used to working in situations like this. It's a critical situation.
Yeah. Tell us about this little boy. Is it Sergey?
Yeah, Sergey. So I met Sergey. He was one of the boys that I met at the refugee accommodation centre. He came over and wanted to talk to me about his experience of being there and leaving his home. He was a very confident young boy who had a lot to say about how he wanted to return to his country, what he wanted for his future. He wanted to say thank you very much to everyone who had supported the kids and families at that centre to be able to provide them with activities, to warm accommodation, food, all of that. And he was just a very brave young man. He's, you know, one of so many part of so many families that are in that situation right now. You see these kids just, you know, even just having the moment to be able to play a game of badminton bounce a ball around. I've never seen so many children happy about just getting one ball. It was so simple.
Play with. What about their mothers? Many of them, as you mentioned, have left their partners behind. Mm-hmm. How are they coping?
Yeah, I think for them, there's a lot of people who are incredibly concerned about whether they're going to have a home to go home to. Mm-hmm. Not only just leaving their partners and so forth, but they really don't. I spoke to a young mother whose husband was still fighting, but she doesn't have a home to return to. She's at the moment dealing with her child, who is incredibly traumatised by hearing the actual war, the bombs and so forth. So for her to be able to have a day where her child can have some fun, for her it was just for her to be able to relax in that moment as well. It was really important for just to have those moments without any kind of anxiety, without any stress, without any of that trauma right on the doorstep. But they are there's certainly a lot of the mothers and grandparents were there filming to send home the footage to their partners who are back in Ukraine fighting, just to show them that their families are safe, that they are, you know, having moments of some joy.
Yeah.
Yeah, just that little bit of respite goes such a long way. We've got some pictures as well of a distribution event run by Child Fund. I've got some pictures that we're going to show you now. You're handing out some more colouring books here toys and stuff for the kids. This is the face painting you're telling us about?
Yeah, so we set up face painting and they were able to paint as well. In the bag there are some snacks and everything. I visited this amazing farm that have dedicated now. They're like an ecological agricultural centre. They've donated all of their space now and their workers to creating fruit straps.
Yeah.
So the kids can have that, so it's not they're non-perishable as well, and they're creating highly nutritious snacks like grain snacks for the kids to eat as well, but also ones that they have in the Ukraine. So they're eating familiar
taste of
food
home.
As well,
a
taste of home.
Really.
So, but they're also creating jobs for the Moldovan people as well, who are at a deficit themselves in terms of their economy. So it's looking at that sustainability as well, like what they can put in place for the future, like turning the refugee accommodation centres, here's hoping when everything is over and there's still a long way to go, they're still going to deal with a lot of traumatised kids and parents, but they're also putting things in place for the future of Moldova as well, for the kids to go back to school.
Just incredible. Do they believe in their hearts that they will get home one day? Is that what's keeping them going?
I think so. When you're dealing with people that have been so cruelly displaced, and even with that knowledge that they don't have a home, an actual physical home to return to, it's very hard to pull someone away from their own country and not expect them to want to go home. It's what they're familiar with. It's where their grounds are, their roots, their history, their families. I think that things are going to be ramping up again. As you can see, there's already 15 million people that have been displaced from Ukraine. Mm. That's over half of Australia.
Yeah,
wow.
That's right.
So if you look at it from that perspective, and so many of those children and incredibly vulnerable people that are going to be living with a lifelong wounds from this, psychological, emotional, and physical, obviously. But with people's help, and I've seen it on the ground. That's the thing; I can see it when I'm on the ground. The Alliance there—they're providing medical assistance. They're providing psychological support for the kids, which is going to be ongoing, which is incredibly important. It's not just about giving them food and basic essentials, but to also support their emotional and psychological development from here, which has already been undermined by what's happening there.
It reminds us how lucky we are here.
Oh, yeah.
Well, and that was the thing. I got to jump on a plane and come home.
Yeah.
And that, for me, and the least I can do is share the message, is to show people what's happening over there and say anything, it does make a difference. Just, head to Child Fund and just donate
Whatever you can.
Because it does help. And who knows, one day we might need that here. You never know,
That's right.
And pay it forward, I say.
Childfund.org is the place to go to support this incredible charity. Danielle, seeing the work that your dollars do over there, so support the charity if you can. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you so much.
Nice to have you back safe and sound.